Hey there, YouTube. Dubs Rider here. And figured I would try to do something a little different today. I've gotten a lot of questions on how the Honda CTX 1300 compares to the Honda F6B. And I think they're kind of maybe targeted at a similar group of individuals. So two different bikes kind of trying to go after that same niche. And I kind of put myself into that niche, somebody that wants something comfortable, but I'm not quite ready to step up to a full Goldwing yet. And and I don't really know that it's because the bike is a bad bike. I had a GL1200 and 86 GL1200, and I absolutely love that bike. I didn't get to ride it a whole lot because it was just one thing after another with that bike, trying to get it going. But I actually did like the bike. It had a lot of good features and stuff on it. But I'm not really ready to plop down that money on a Goldwing. So I would like to go out here and to one of my local Honda shops here and see if we could work something out where I could test ride an F6B and kind of compare it. Now, the other bike that this is often confused with is the VTX 1300. So they've got the Honda CTX 1300 and the Honda VTX 1300. And the VTX is a V-twin, more of a classic cruiser style bike. And so a lot of times this gets confused with that bike as well when people are trying to look up information on this bike. But I think the prices themselves have gotten to a point where I think last I heard on this one, you can get one of these brand new, maybe not a deluxe, but you can get a standard base model brand new for right around 10 grand. And we'll see what the local price is on an F6B, but last I knew it was right around 12 grand. Or 12.9, somewhere in there. And so now they're a lot more comparable from a price standpoint. And even when they first were launched, I think this one was 17.5 or something. And the Honda F6B was 19.99 or something, or 18.99. Honda's all funny with their pricing, so it's kind of hard to figure that out most of the time. But I think they're running a promotion right now to try to move some of these larger cruisers. And so now you're not looking at as large of an investment for either bike. So I figured it would be a good opportunity for me to kind of go test ride one and see what I think of it compared to my CTX 1300. I think many of you know that I do love this bike. But I know the Goldwing is that upper echelon of Honda's motorcycles, and it's got the GL1800 in it, which is a tried and true motor for Honda. They've been putting that motor in there since, I believe, right around 2003. They switched over to the GL1800 as from the GL1500. So, six-cylinder as opposed to a four-cylinder or V4 motor in this bike should produce quite a bit more power. But you're going to be looking at a weight difference too. I believe the bike is almost 60 pounds or 70 pounds heavier than this bike. So it's something definitely to think about, depending on where you're going, you know, what you want to do with a motorcycle. But I definitely think that either one of them at this point is a good value. So I figured I'd go ride it and see what my thoughts are and see if I fall in love with it like I did this motorcycle when I rode it. So don't know that I'm planning on getting rid of this motorcycle, at least anytime soon, but Hey, you never know. I've been looking at a smaller bike actually to replace my, or not replace my CTX, but just something small to kind of bomb around town. And I think Two Wheel Obsession was kind of looking at doing the same thing. But you know, when you've got a larger bike like this, it's sometimes it's nice to get this one on the highway and go on a little bit longer ride. But sometimes when you just want to take a short trip around town, you want something light and you want something nimble. Really something that you know, you can go short distances on and you don't have to worry about comfort quite so much. So that's definitely something to take into account, and I'm going to be looking at some of those bikes, so you might see some test rides coming up for some smaller bikes and stuff that I would like to maybe add to the collection with. My wife's got the Spider, and you know, I don't mind the Spider, but that's more of a long distance two-up travel thing for me. I don't think I'm quite ready to jump on three wheels unless it was for an F3 at this point. So yeah, we're gonna go out here and see if I can't put together a test ride on the F6B, and I'll come back at you in a little bit. All right. Hey there, YouTube. Finally got a F6B to test ride. And just pulled out of the parking lot there. And I wanna kinda compare this to the 1300 and what I think between the two. I can tell you, it feels like there's less in front of you. That might just be the windshield. I'm not quite sure what that is. The mirrors are phenomenal compared to my bike. I don't know if they're just because it's a little bit higher. I mean, but I could definitely see everything behind me, which is great. And I apologize in advance if the wind noise is a little bit louder on this, but the windshield is pretty much non-existent. It hits you about neck level. But yeah, this thing's got power. That's for sure. And it's really smooth too. Now, talking to the guys in there, this is about 14, I think he said he had on it. And this isn't the deluxe model. The deluxe model's got cruise on it and stuff, but this is not the deluxe model. It's just the basic standard model. So fairly close. I noticed they vary by dealership to dealership. My bike is going for 12.9 in there, or 11.9 in there, $12,000. This is 14, so very close. You're within striking distance. This is a 2013 model. It's not a 2014. So it doesn't have cruise control because it is the standard. It does have lots of storage, lots of different compartments. I think they put this Kiriakin thing in there separately. But yeah, it feels really nimble for such a big bike. It feels really nimble. And it feels really short. And it's got plenty of power, that's for sure. I'll find a little spot to kind of turn around and do a walk around so you can kind of see the different features on the bike. But so far, I really do like it. I think it's got a little bit more relaxed riding position compared to mine. It definitely sits into the corners really well. Very little input at all. Just sit it down in a corner and it tracks and stays there, which is really nice. I'm not so sure I'm a fan of the red color, but You know, color's not that big of a deal to me personally anyway. But yeah, it's really light and nimble considering it's a big bike here. The gears feel solid. Very good for shifting. You feel a nice solid clunk in there. The clutch is a pretty light pull. I don't know if it's got hydraulic assisted clutch or not, but it definitely has a really light clutch pull on it. You got your radio and all of that jazz in this section right here. So you've got your radio, your mute, and all of that. As far as I understand, there's quite a few more accessories for this bike too. Very good engine braking. Handles that very well. You can just barely hear the thing. So quiet. Brakes feel a little spongy, but that could be that it's been sitting in a... Wow. Very slim friction zone there. I mean, it's a matter of just a little hair of a pull and it's pulling. So that would take some getting used to for sure. Doesn't look like it's got self-canceling turn signals, which not the end of the world, but it's kind of handy to have. Definitely feels like less bike in front of you, I guess, even though it seems like a lot more. I don't feel like you sit into the bike quite as much as you do on the CTX 1300. But it's definitely got way more power. I mean, this thing's got get up and go for days. Way more power. You really don't feel the extra weight in the bike at all. It really doesn't feel any heavier to me while I'm riding it. If anything, I think it feels a little lighter. Pull in there. Used to be dirt in there. If I can find a spot to kind of pull over here. That's got some... Got some cement. Really don't want to put a dealer bike in the dirt. Beautifully though. I can't get over how much you can see out of the mirrors. I know it's a small thing, but wow. No strain at all to see what's behind you. I know when I test rode the Harley, I was not overly impressed. It wasn't a bad bike, but I was not overly impressed. With this bike, I'm actually pretty impressed. I like the power and the nimbleness. And it's very, very quiet compared to my bike. So we'll kind of pull over here and I'll do a walk around. But I don't know if it's coming through in the microphone or not. Let me open my visor here. It is very, very quiet. Still has the side dropping saddlebags, which I'm not sure if I'm a huge fan of. It doesn't seem like it's too much longer than my bike. It might be a little bit longer than my bike, but not too much. Like I said, you really feel the difference in the front end through here. Doesn't feel like it's quite as long as my bike. Nissan brakes. Like I said, they felt a little spongy, but that could have been that it was sitting in the showroom for a while. I mean, it is a 13, so it has been sitting around for a while. I like the headlights on it. Looks like it's got some spots for some fog lights down there. And it's got the drop bars in case you put it down on its side. But it's definitely not hard to get on and off the side stand, that's for sure. Oh, I think I still had the center stand down, or the side stand down. Neat little Honda thing they did there. I do it on my bike too. If your side stand's down and you go to put it in gear, it turns the bike off. Now that it's warmed up a little bit, we're gonna give it a test here. Got up the speed pretty good there. It's got plenty of power. Very, very different sound when you get on it than it does on my bike. Very different sound. And notice once it gets up in fifth gear, you get that overdrive thing. And I think I had that on my GL1200 too. I think it's just a gas saving technique. I'm not quite sure. I'm not overly familiar with Goldwings, but yeah, I mean, this is a really nice bike. Tracks really well. It feels sticky on the road. And I know you can do a lot of things with tires, but yeah, it's just feels like a really light and nice bike. Absolutely no issue at all going 60-70 miles an hour on this thing. I have a feeling that it would do this all day with no problem. I mean, it's only at 2.5 RPMs and we're at, you know, 60 miles an hour, so. And if I was to give it some gas like this, that quick to get up to 70. Not very bad at all. So if you need to pass somebody or get out around somebody, you got plenty of power. I think it has gobs of power on it. It feels a little smoother than my bike too, from a road perspective too. It's a little less bumpy. Just feels more solid. Give these brakes a test here. Not bad. I'm not so sure if I'm a fan of the first gear thing. It's just hangs out there. Feels like it keeps plopping down. You get down to first gear and it just, normally you have to, you know, once you get down to first gear, the shifter stays down. And this seems like it just continues to just kind of go nowhere. That would take some getting used to. really nice bike. I think maybe if I was buying mine all over again, I might look in this direction first. Just for me personally though, I don't think that there's enough upside for me to actually move to this, to something like this. Yes, it's a really nice smooth riding bike, but so is mine. Yes, it's got more power, but mine's got plenty for me. Mine tracks really well in the corners, feels stable. It's not quite as smooth as this. I give it that. This bike is incredibly smooth. Honda definitely has the suspension worked out on these things really nicely. You barely feel anything in the road. But it's definitely, I don't know that it's something that I would upgrade for my bike to get this bike kind of thing. But definitely, if you're looking at getting a CTX 1300, don't sleep on this one. Give this one a test ride and see which one you like better. They're so close in price now that it can't hurt to see which one you prefer better. So yeah, that's all I got for you guys. Just kind of a short test ride here to give it a run through the paces and see how I like it. And please like and subscribe, guys. You can find me on my social media links below. You can also like and subscribe below. And yeah, until next time, guys, ride safe.